So this is the ray track analysis model result. This is the additional module of MIDAS server, which composed of the these 5 tab: layout, span, boundary, load, and result option. If we see those options one by one, so I will open the program and then I will show you. So this is the wizard, which you can find from under the structure, and there is the ray track analysis module. So from this wizard, firstly, we can specify the bridge related data for the bridge material. This material we simply specify from the material property and length of the embankment and the deck, number of span, and each of the lengths. Also the span type, how the support will be applied, we can specify from here. So generally used type, we can simply select from here, or we can make the different type of the support, like fixed or ruler, we can specify from here. So up to even we can specify more number of spans, maximum number of span for a certain one deck. So since at the moment we specified 10 different deck and maximum number of span is 4, that's why only 4 span is there up to the 10 decks. So once we try to change the certain value, then we can also apply the related support condition from here. For now, we will just use the simply supported condition. And for the ray data, we can similarly specify the ray material and number of tracks. We can specify 1 or 2 tracks. As the UIC standard specified, only up to 2 tracks we need to apply. That's why only those 2 can be selected from here. And as I mentioned, when the axial stress exceeds than our expectation, in that case we need to review the zero lateral resistance fastener or rail expansion joint. So those can also be simulated from the wizard. For the zero lateral resistance fastener, we can specify the start point and the end point. Then the longitudinal movement for this specified region will be the rail can be freely moved for this region, which means the stiffness of the spring will be differently applied. There will be no restraint for the spring. And if we consider the rail expansion joint for the certain point, which is expected to have the maximum axial stress, then we will see the disconnection of the rail. So which means there will be the expansion joint is installed. So those options can be used. And if we move to the section tab, we can specify the bridge section and the rail section. For the bridge section, it's same. So we can specify section from here. Even we can use the general sections entered from the SPC. And tapered section can also be used. So for the each of the span, each of the deck, I mean, different type of the taper span can be entered from here. Also for the rail, if we want to enter the rail size with the UIC standard section, we can simply select the UIC from here. Once we click add, then new rail section will be automatically applied. So this section is already entered from using the SPC, it's like the built-in section, so we can use this option, or you can specify your own layer section, and then we can specify it from here. Eccentricity between the deck and layer can be entered. So considering the layer height of the ballast, we can enter this value. And so depending on the offset position of the deck, if the offset of the deck is top, then eccentricity will this much. But if our section has the centroid of the offset, then we can specify the eccentricity from the centroid. Even also similarly from the bottom, we can enter it. And in case of the our wizard, we do not model the layer for those two. For the one track, only one layer will represent the one track, which means the in order to have the stress for the each of the layer, we need to get the results from the results after the analysis, and then we need to divide the stress because one beam element will represent two layers for the one certain track. So if we, as you can see, the only the T1 and T2 will be specified. So we do not need to be worried about the distance between the layer for one track, just to, at the center, we can enter the distance for each of the track. Let's move to the boundary tab. In the boundary, as I mentioned, we need to consider different stiffness for the loaded condition and unloaded condition. So for the loaded condition and unloaded condition, as you can see from here, we can specify the spring resistance from here. And for the stress check and displacement check, if required, we can specify different values. Also, if we have the concrete bed, not the ballast bed, we will have the different resistance. That value can be specified from here. And this letter limit displacement, which is UD in this graph, can be specified from this field, same as the ballast bed. We can specify whether we will have the ballast bed or concrete bed from here, or if required, we can make the combination between the ballast bed and concrete bed. As you can see, we can specify the desired length and with the different condition of the ballast, we can specify. And this is a boundary condition for the deck. We can make the bottom of the deck with the point spring support with this stiffness. We can specify the stiffness from here, or we can make the pier for our boundary of the deck. When we model the pier, we can specify the pier section from here, and at the bottom of the pier, whether it will be the fixed support or point spring support, we can select. Also, the pier height can be specified. There is the guide picture. So when we specify the spring type bearing, or when we specify the bearing type bearing, you can see. So when there is the spring type bearing and section offset of the deck is centroid, then between the bottom and the centroid, it will be rigidly connected using rigid link. In the bottom, we will enter the point spring support. If we model the bearing, then up to here it's same. After that, for the bearing, we will model it using the elastic link. Then pier will be modeled using the beam element. The advantage of this wizard is modeling time. Actually, this Without this wizard, we were able to perform the rail structure interaction analysis using CWR. So there was no new certain feature, but the modeling time, it took very long time for you to check this rail and structure interaction. The reason is we need to consider we need to enter manually so many springs, and it's very complex for this embankment and the joint between the embankment and deck, and even the between the decks. We need to be very careful, and there must be a lot of modeling mistake, and it takes very long time for making each of these spring one by one. Also, as I mentioned, the spring stiffness is changed depending on the loading condition with the train and without train. That's why the modeling time took, for example, one or two days only for the modeling, but this modeling time will be significantly reduced using the wizard, like just 1 hour. So complex part we can see from this embankment and the joint part. So for the embankment part, layer will be modeled and the soil will be modeled using the fixed support, and between two will be connected using the multilinear type elastic link. So their stiffness in the longitudinal direction is not the rigid. That's why we need to consider its stiffness using the multilinear type elastic link and different stiffness for the loaded condition and unloaded condition. For the embankment part, so actually those two is same position of the node. One is simulating the representing the embankment, the other one is representing the beginning of the deck. And this beginning of the deck will be also rigidly connected with the deck support. So even though there is two nodes, we need to have different multilinear link, and they will have different the boundary support. Also between the two deck, generally in order to have the smaller displacement and extra stress, we prefer to have the simply supported deck, and which means the deck will be continued, but two different nodes will be there. Even though it is the same position, two different deck nodes will be there, and one node for the previous deck, the other one for the next deck, and they are connected to the rail using the multilinear elastic link, and they are connected to the bottom of the deck for the peer support. So by modeling like this, we can simulate the simply supported condition deck, and this deck will also show with the very continuous without any gap between the deck. If we move to the load tab, as I mentioned at the beginning, we need to consider the three type of the loading. One is temperature load. So as you can see, we can specify the load for the deck or both deck and rail. And the other load is longitudinal train load, like the acceleration and braking load. So we can specify the desired loading type from here. And the other one is the train vertical load. Train vertical load can be entered, as you can see. So we can specify the loading value, and that loading value will be entered as a beam load. Starting point and end point will be specified. And if we want to specify not the beam load, if you want to enter the point load, what you can do is we can simply enter the same position of the start and end by entering like this. Then the point, it will be entered as a point load. So this is the way how we can enter both train beam load and the point load for the longitudinal and vertical train load. There is another option which showing the moving load data. Actually, this train load is entered not like the moving load feature in MIDAS server. It is just a simple beam load static analysis. And we may want to check the most critical position of the train. So for this purpose, we provide this option, which means if I enter the number of track loading location 3, and then location increments as 10 meter, it means the train will start from the position specified in here, and the 3 different models will be generated, which considering the train load moving with the 10 meter, and the other model 20 meter train load moving, and the other model 30 meter train load moving. Like this way, we can check the stress and the displacement separately, and then we can find out the most critical position. So number of different model will be automatically generated using this option. Finally, we can go to this wizard option. As I mentioned, the beam, the tech, and rail will be modeled using the beam element. And what will be the unit length of the beam element? Depending on this element length, then the distance between the spring will be changed. So generally, 1 meter is recommended value as per the UIC standard. So you can see the default value as 1 meter, but if required, we can enter the different element lengths. And for the checking purpose, we can perform the simplified analysis or complete analysis. Complete analysis is the one which considering the construction sequence. So with the train load or without the train load, only considering the thermal load, and second stage with the train load, we can go those type of the analysis using this complete analysis model, or we can go simplified separate model to have different type of the model, which for checking the longitudinal relative displacement or the displacement due to the train vertical load, so on. So let's try to generate the complete analysis model from here. So once I click OK, so model is generated as you can see. This is the folder that I saved my model file. So firstly, we can see the 4 different type of the model has been generated just before. And one model and the other model named with the moving 1, 2, 3, which means when I generate the model with the wizard, you may remember this option. So I wanted to consider the 3 different model additionally with the train moving with the 10 meter. So that's why the 4 different model has been generated in my folder automatically. So if we check starting from the initial model, so let's see details how the model is generated. So as you can see, I have specified I want to consider the 2 different track. So 2 layer is generated for representing each of the track. And firstly, this was the staged model, complete type model. So for the complete type model, in the unloaded stage, we will only have the thermal load on the deck. And in the next stage, and this stage, the which is the unloaded stage, if we go to the table, this is the point spring support. And if we go to the elastic link, thermal ballast stiffness is considered using this multilinear type elastic link, and we can see in the unloaded condition, the stiffness ultimate resistance is 20 for the unloaded condition. And this is only the y direction of the elastic link. I will show you the elastic link. So elastic link is entered like this. For this, elastic link is the one which representing the ballast stiffness. So we just checked unloaded condition stiffness is applied in the first stage. And this is the part for the embankment. So in the embankment part, if we display the support. So fixed condition support is applied to simulate the embankment. And at the bottom of the deck, we can see the support. And this support has no restraint in the longitudinal direction because we considered the longitudinal direction support using the point spring support with this stiffness we specified from the wizard. So in the same position, different type of the spring stiffness is considered even this support. And if we go to the next stage, which is the loaded stage, in this stage now we will see the train load. So as you can see in the tree menu, we can see the train load. Firstly, for the train traction and braking force. Also, we can see the train vertical load. And if we check the stiffness of the elastic link, which is representing the ballast resistance, let's go to the table again. Now in the loaded stage, so as you can see in the certain position, for example this position, so loaded stiffness is now entered with the different value of the spring stiffness, which is the 60. So as you can see in the different construction stages, different ballast resistance is automatically applied. So that is about the longitudinal direction of the elastic link and other direction like the transverse direction or vertical direction. We can see that with the very large stiffness in this elastic tab, which means they are almost rigidly connected. So only the longitudinally they have the certain resistance, and the other direction they are rigidly connected using the elastic link. So this was the one model that we considered. And if we see each of the deck, so let me display the support. So 10 different deck we wanted to consider. So this is the deck position, and as you can see, in the same position, two nodes are displayed. Two nodes are selected in one certain position. One is for the previous deck, and the other one is for next deck. So in order to simulate this simply supported condition, two different nodes which are not connected to each other is there. And if we check the movement of the train with a different model, firstly, our train load was starting from this deck starting position. And if I open the other model, automatically generated, like moving one, in the second stage, we can see the train moving. So previously, the loading was starting from here, and now 10 meters above, the train was moving. And the other model again, 10 meters above again. So with the different position of the train, the model is automatically generated. If we check the results obtained from this model, so from this complete model, I performed the analysis already, and we want to check the axial stress. So axial stress, firstly for the unloaded condition only with the train load, I will display only the rail, and we can check the axial stress. As you can see here, and from this axial stress, we can see the maximum and minimum axial stress from this region, and even moving to the loaded condition. Again, in the loaded condition, with considering the train load, we can see the axial stress. So let's go back to the presentation.